I'm going to show you how to use After Effects and a 2B pencil to create this animation. My plan was to create a short looping animation in After Effects and then redraw every frame by hand to create a lot of charm and texture that frame by frame animation tends to have, and experiment with blending traditional and digital animation. To create maximum impact for the amount of work required, I decided it needed to loop and be animated at 12 frames per second. So by drawing just 12 frames, I could create many seconds worth of viewing. I decided on this design of an eye with an iris zooming in infinitely and lines rotating inside that. I started in a 5-second long comp that is 12 frames per second, and I've created a circle straight in the middle. I'm going to animate its scale by making it 0 at the very beginning, and then a few seconds later, increasing its scale so it encompasses the whole composition. I'm going to add some easing to the very first keyframe, and then in the graph editor, just make that a little sharper. Then I'm going to duplicate that layer, change its fill color to white, and then offset it by 6 frames, which will be half of our 12 second loop. I'm going to select and duplicate both of these with Ctrl D, and then I'm going to drag them over and offset them by 6 frames each again, and keep doing that to fill up the comp. Now we've got our infinite zoom. I'm going to drag my work area to be 12 frames long, and I'm going to slide all these back until they fill up the entire screen. There, now we've got our 1 second loop within these 12 frames. For the rotating lines, I've created a new comp that's a bit larger than our main comp, and I've got one line coming out from the exact center. I'm going to add a repeater. I'm going to add repeater, give it 12 copies, and change the transform on the repeater to its position to be 0, and its rotation to be 30. And I'm going to zoom in and adjust that anchor point so it all lines up in the middle. There we are. I made the rotation 30 degrees, so each copy would be rotated an additional 30 degrees, and over 12 copies that would fill out a complete circle. To figure out the angle you need to make a full circle, you can click into the rotation field and do some simple math in there. So we can do 360 and forward slash, which means division, and then the number of copies you have. So we have 12. So it's going to calculate 360 divided by 12, which is 30 degrees. And like an absolute nerd, After Effects will do all of the math for you. Now let's duplicate this lines layer as well, add a rotation at the beginning of our work area here, and then at the end, let's rotate this by 30 degrees as well. So now we've got a rotation that lines up with the next line. Great. Here's what that looks like back in our main comp. To get the warping on this comp, I'm gonna add the effect twirl. Now this is a really fun effect. I definitely recommend you just go in and play with all the different settings. I ended up with the angle of 120 and the radius of 100. So it fills our entire comp. But you can easily push this angle further to get like a really intense spiral. Now let's create our eye shape by double clicking on the ellipse tool up here. Double clicking on a shape up here will create a shape that fills our entire comp. Let's call that eye because we always label our layers. And if we toggle down to its path, we need to right click and select convert to Bezier path so we can make some adjustments. And I'm gonna select my convert to vertex tool over here. And I'm just gonna click on the left and right Bezier points. And clicking on them will remove their Bezier handles and create this nice almond shape that we see. And now if we set its blending mode to stencil alpha, it'll turn everything underneath it in that layer stack transparent that isn't included within the shape. So everything not in that shape becomes transparent. And let's duplicate that again. And let's change the blending mode back to normal. Go back to our pen tool and I'm gonna adjust this top handle and drag that down to create a nice eyelid. And I'm gonna fill that with some gray. And now our base animation is complete. Let's get ready for printing. I duplicated that comp to create a printer-friendly version so I didn't waste any black ink. So I made the black fills very pale gray and then added a black stroke to some of the circles. I then made a new comp with this layer with some additional information that I wanted to be on each printout. I created these registration marks down here, which just masks over a comp with two rectangles in it so that we just get those crosshairs. And then I've also added a frame counter on the top left here, just so I know what order the frames are going to be in when I import them and scan them back in. And you can add this by simply adding the timecode effect that I've added to an adjustment layer. I then added this to the render queue and then set its output module to be a PNG sequence, which will render an image for every frame. I traced over these using this Huion A4 light pad. Huion sent me this and this was the first time I used it. If you don't have a light box, you can trace over your guides by either holding your paper up to a window, using some very thin paper, or just drawing straight over your printouts. A good light box does give you more flexibility, and this one feels and works great. The build quality is nice and it's very light. It just plugs into a USB port and you're off running. And I'm going to trace over it with standard 80 GSM A4 printing paper. The light pad comes with a clip, but because I'm going to be rotating this a lot and I'm not worried about damaging the top paper at all, I use two pieces of masking tape to keep them aligned. The first thing we need to do is mark down the frame number and trace over the registration marks as closely as possible. And that will make aligning them in After Effects a lot easier. From here, I traced over the outlines for each of the frames. And once the outlining is done, we can turn the light off and start rendering. Now this is the part that takes a lot of time. It took me about 15 to 20 minutes for each frame, which for 12 frames came out to just under 4 hours. So a perfect time to spend the afternoon catching up on podcasts, or just contemplating your existence and asking yourself, am I just a render engine made of sentient meat? I put another piece of paper under my right hand as well to stop me smudging it as I drew. I wasn't too careful about being precise because the whole point of this was to make it look hand-drawn and give it some unique texture that I couldn't fake in After Effects. Towards the end, I started to fear that the way I was shading them made the dark areas look a bit like a donut-y sphincter. So please, don't mention that in the comments. I know it's a bit sphinctery in the middle. Let's leave it at that. Once they were all done, I scanned them in and imported them into After Effects. So I imported them into a comp and then added some guides to make aligning them up a little easier. I just set the anchor point up into the corner here where our registration mark is, and then just kept nudging the rotation until it lined up with all the others. And this is close enough. And here's what the scanned in files look like. I was pretty happy with it. It's pretty close to what I had imagined. The boil and the texture feel really nice. Maybe I imagined it a tad less sphinctery, but that's the joys of animation. Happy accidents. I think it kind of looks cool with the, you know, the boiling of the registration marks and even with the tape as well. I cleaned it up by adding a mask just around the eye to clean up all the smudges and registration marks and all that other stuff. And then I added a curves effect to increase the contrast. And that was pretty much it for cleaning it up. I decided to play around with duplicating that comp and offsetting each one by a frame. So each frame has all 12 drawings in it. This I thought looked really cool. And I was really trying to milk those frames for all they were worth, just to make myself feel a little bit better about spending so much time drawing them. I also tried laying them out in a circle, which I thought looked kind of neat. And then rotating that circle looked kind of neat as well. I landed on this square one, with 12 copies being my favorite combination to put on social media. It was close enough to see the pencil textures in the eyeball, but it had enough copies so it still had a bit more impact. It took about 6 hours all up to get this result. I did learn a bunch and had some fun along the way, and also got something that I couldn't have done just inside a computer. But let me know, was it worth it? I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.